Hello friends, this is Durga from IIT University. This video is part of a course called as CCA Data Analyst in which HiveScoop and Impala are covered quite extensively. If you want to learn any of these technologies or prepare for the certification, you can enroll for our course for $10 by going through the information in description. Also, we provide something called as Big Data Developer Labs. If you want to sign up for the labs and practice, you can actually go to the description and click on the link to get details about the labs. If you are not subscribed to our channel yet, please do so by clicking on the subscribe button and also click on notify button so that you get notified whenever we create free content as part of our channel. Let us understand how we can develop a self-contained script which contains all Impala commands or queries and then run it using Impala shell. If you look at the help of Impala shell, there is a control argument called as -f where we should be able to pass a query file. We can also use --- query file with equal to sign and then we should be able to pass that query file. That query file should contain all valid Impala commands or queries. That being said, I am creating a new script called as load daily revenue. So in this, I'll be creating new tables called as orders and order items. If they already exist, I just want to ignore. If they do not exist, I just want to create those tables. Then I want to load the data into those tables with overwrite option so that it only have the one copy of the data. Once these tables are loaded, I want to create a new table called as daily revenue with two fields. One is order date and second one is the order revenue. And then by querying from orders and order items on complete as well as closed orders, I just want to group by order date and then compute the daily revenue and load into that new table. I want to create a self-contained script so that I can run it using Impala shell. So in this case, I have launched this VA editor with loaddailyrevenue.iql. First and foremost, if the database does not exist, I just want to create, and hence I can use create database if not exists retail_db. So if the database already exists, it will just ignore. If the database doesn't exist, it will just create the database. Once it is created, I want to create the table called as orders. Even in this case, if the table already exists, I don't want to fail. And hence I'm saying create table if not exists. And this orders dataset have four fields. They are nothing but order ID, which is of type integer, order date, which is of type string, order customer ID, which is of type integer, order status, which is of type string. Now I can say row format delimited fields terminated by comma because I want to load the comma separated data into this table. Same is the case with order items. So here I'm copy pasting this create table command and then refactoring to actually reflect whatever is relevant with respect to order items. So the table name is order items. The first field is order item ID. There are six fields in this. The last field is nothing but order item product price, which is of type float. The fifth field is nothing but order item subtotal, which is also of type float. The fourth field is nothing but order item quantity. It is of type integer. The third field is nothing but order item product ID, which is also of type integer. The second one is nothing but order item order ID. Once we create these two tables, we have to load the data into these tables. However, with respect to Impala, we'll not be able to load from local directories, and hence first we need to copy data into the HDFS location. We also need to have write permissions so that we can actually move the data from that HDFS location into the tables. And hence we have to run some HadoopFS commands. For that, we should be able to use this shell approach. So using shell, I can say HadoopFS-put. The location for our files in local file system in this gateway node is nothing but home, ITVarsity, data, RetailDB, orders, and the HDFS location where I want to copy is nothing but user, ITVarsity, retail_db. Also, if the data already exists, I just want to forcefully overwrite, and hence I can say -f here. After this, I have to change the permissions also, so I can say HadoopFS-chmod-R777, then user, ITVarsity, RetailDB, orders. Because to run load command using Impala, that session has to have the right permissions on the source location from where we are trying to move data into the table. So now I can actually copy these two lines, paste it here, and then refactor for order items. So in this case, the directory name is nothing but order items, from where I want to copy data into user ITVarsity retail. Also, when it comes to this one, the location is order items to change the permission. This will take care of loading the data. However, all these commands need to end with semicolon. So let me add semicolon here for each and every command. Now I can say load data in path. The location for orders data is nothing but this one. Paste it here. and then into table orders. If you just want to handle the situation where the table already exists, then you have to say overwrite table orders. I'm not sure about the syntax, it can be overwrite into table, but we will fix if it actually run into issue. Now I can copy this, paste it, and then change this to order items. Then finally, I want to create another table, which is nothing but daily revenue. In this case, I just want to use CTAS, which is nothing but create table name as select, and then I want to query the data from the two tables which are created, and then create this new table called as daily revenue. So here I can say create table name as select order date sum of order item subtotal as order revenue from orders O join order items OI on O dot order ID equal to Y dot order item order ID where O dot order status in complete closed then group by order date. Here I just want to refer all these things with aliases. So here I can say O dot order date, O dot order date, and then Y dot order item subtotal. Now I can save this and come out of this. Then I can say Impala hyphen shell hyphen I. So either I can say hyphen hyphen Impala D or hyphen I to refer to the Impala D server to which I want to connect to run this query. So in this case, I want to connect to Big Data Server hyphen 5 colon 21,000. And then I can say hyphen F. I want to give the fully qualified path of the file, which is nothing but home, IT varsity, and then load daily revenue.iql. You can also give the relative path. If you want to give the relative path, you have to be in the appropriate directory. And then you should be able to give the relative path from the directory. So from the current directory, the relative path is nothing but load daily revenue.iql itself. So either you can give fully qualified path like this, or as you already in home IT varsity, you should just say load daily revenue.iql. Now we can hit enter. It has created both the tables. Now it is loading data into the tables. First, it is actually copying the files into the orders and order items. However, this load command is not correct. That's why it is failing. So I have to fix it and I have to rerun it. So here I am opening once again. I think here I have to say overwrite into table. Now I just have to rerun this once again. So now the tables are ignored because as part of the earlier run, the tables are recreated. Now the files are being copied to the HDFS locations, which is nothing but user IT varsity retail DB orders and order items. And again, it is running into some issue. The issue is permission denied by sticky bit user equal to Impala, path equal to user hive warehouse, orders, part hyphen 5 zeros. Okay, I know the issue. So in this case, I have created the database and then everything is running on the default database. However, we have to say use retail underscore DB to switch to the appropriate database. And then let me run this. Now it is running fine. As this table already exists, it is failing. So I just have to fix it and then we should be able to rerun it once again. So here I can say create table if not exists, and then I can run it. Or if you want to make sure that every time this runs, you can say drop table daily revenue like this, so that the table will be dropped every time and then be recreated using this CTAS command. Now I can come out of this and I should be able to run this command. Now the tables are created. The data is being loaded into HDFS locations, which are nothing but slash user slash IT varsity retail DB orders and slash user slash IT varsity retail DB order items. Then it actually loaded the data into orders and order items in retail DB database. And then it actually dropped the table daily revenue and created this table once again by that name. By querying the results from this query, it actually loaded the 364 rows into the table called as daily revenue. Now I can launch the Impala shell just by saying Impala shell hyphen I big data server colon 21,000. Hit enter, go to retail DB by saying use retail underscore DB and then say show tables. You should be able to see all the three tables and you should be able to query data from daily revenue. So whenever you run the scripts using Impala shell, make sure the script is self-contained using some of the features that are available with respect to Hive or Impala. So in this case, when I actually developed this script called as load daily revenue.iql, I have used if not exists while creating databases or tables. It is because if the database already exists, I just want to ignore. If the database doesn't exist, I want to create. If we do not add this if not exists, if the database or table already exists, it will just fail there itself. So if there is any error or exception at any point in this script, it will stop abruptly over there itself. And hence, it is better to ensure that you use some of these features so that everything is self-contained and will be running without any issues. Once the database is created, I have switched to the database, then created these tables called as orders and order items with appropriate delimiters. Then we have used this shell approach to actually copy data from local file system into HDFS. Also, as Impala requires write permissions on these HDFS locations to use as part of the load commands, we have changed the permission to 777. Once that is done, we have used this load commands to load data from this HDFS location into table orders, and then this HDFS location into table order items. Then if the daily revenue already exists, we just want to drop it and then recreate with the query results after joining orders and order items with where condition, where we only check for complete and closed orders, and then using order date as part of the group by, we have computed the order revenue. So this is a self-contained script. If you think that every day you get new data set in these local file system locations, which are nothing but this one, then every day you should be able to run this script by scheduling using schedulers. So make sure you practice a bit on how to develop self-contained scripts so that we can schedule for simple ETL flows where we should be able to leverage Hive or Impala to take care of those things.